that we shall rejoice and continue to be glad on those, even though it is hard to face 3 weeks of some of us. Those who understand will understand what I mean when I say the hard first 3 weeks of the year. But even though Chiefs shall win one day. Chiefs shall win one day. Greetings and welcome to today's service. And today we are celebrating with Sirene Mwate, who is celebrating his birthday. Sirene with us today. And on the 27th, we'll be celebrating the wedding anniversary of Daniel and Achin Osigwe. They'll be celebrating 11 years in marriage. Yes, they are still coming. Shall we bow our feet and pray? Heavenly Lord, we thank you indeed. This is the day that you made for us to come and worship you. Move us, Lord, with your spirit. Let thy will, Lord, be done, not our will. May we see you, Lord, today. As much as we shall feel you, Lord, in our heart. Come, Lord, and be with us. In Christ Jesus we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Our service continues on page 104. Nevertheless, everything shall continue to be projected on the overhead. My dear sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Praise the Lord.
God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence you confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what you have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we receive in newness of life.
Almighty God, forgive all who repent. Have mercy on you. Father, we ask thee to set you free from them, confirm and strengthen you with all goodness, and keep you in life.
Psalm 27, we read verse 1 and we go to 4, verse 12. Appointed Psalm 27, we read verse 1 and we go to 4 to 12. On Anglican prayer books, A634, page 634. I will read the odd verses, you will respond in the evening verses. Psalm 27, page 634. The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom then shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid?
By close people that there is quarreling among you. Individually, these days, I follow Paul, or I follow Apollos, or I follow Cephas, or I follow Christ. Is Christ divided? Was Paul crucified for you, or were you baptized in the name of Paul? I thank God that I baptized none of you except Cephas and Gaius, so that no one may say that you were baptized in my name. I did baptize also the household of Stephanas. Beyond that, I do not know whether I baptized anyone else. For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach gospel, and not with words of eloquent wisdom, lest the cross of Christ be emptied of its power. Christ, the wisdom and power of God. For the word of the cross is only to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved is the power of God. Hear the word of God.
Let's thank you for our record here. By the lake of Zwivhuya. and Naphtali, to fulfill what was said through the prophet Isaiah, "Let the Galilean and land of Naphtali, the way of the sea beyond Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles, the people living in darkness have seen a great light, and those living in the land of shadow of death, a light has grown." From that time on, Jesus began to preach, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is coming." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ.
At once, they left their net and followed him. Going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, preparing their net. Jesus called them, and immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogue, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness among the people. May I speak in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated. This week, I took some time to reflect on the things that happened in the political world. I took some time to reflect on how the parties, which we know, some are the parties that are ruling us, some are the parties which are competing with the party in charge. I had to take some time to reflect on how is their leadership. And as I reflect, I found that within their party, or within people who are following that party or supporting that party, there is a favorite person whom has drawn their attention. We know that there's a party which I won't mention by name, which many of us will say we love that party because so and so in the party is so vocal. You know the party. It's dressed like other people whom they are dressing those t-shirts today. And I got to ask myself that should that member unforeseen happens to him, what will happen to the party? Will it be the end of the party? Apparently, what happens in the world or in the world of the politics, I got to see that in the same things that happens in the church world also. And I got to ask myself that if things are like this, who influences whom? Does the church influence the political parties? Or does the political parties be influenced by the church on how they do things? For even in the church, we say that there is a division. There is a division. For there are people who say in the church that I go to church because so and so is a good minister. Or I go to church on a certain Sunday when so and so is preaching. My question is, should so and so unforeseen happens to him? Will that be the end of your relationship with God? Or should so-and-so get moved to another parish? Are you going to also Are you also going to move there? Relocate with him and leave the church? And this morning, we hear Paul in the epistle to the Corinthians rebuking them, for there was a division within the church. There was a division within the church. For others, they were baptized by Apollos, others they were baptized by Cephas, others they were baptized by Paul. They forgot that the baptism that they were baptized into, it was not a baptism which Paul came and said, I baptize you in the name of God the Father and in the name of God. He said, I baptize you in 3 minutes. In the name of God, Son, in the name of God, Son, and the Holy Spirit. But there was a division among the people there in Corinth. For they started to follow people. They forgot to follow God. They forgot to follow Christ. They started to worship that we are the followers of Paul. They forgot to say that we are the followers of Christ, whom we have seen him through Paul. But they forget that before all the people whom they were dividing church or whom they were following them, they are Christian. And they need to follow Christianity instead of following people. They have to support the ministry of those whom God has placed into them, but they don't have to put them and to put them ahead. They have to follow the Christ cross ahead. For it means that to them, Christianity, it wasn't about being Christ followers. To them, Christianity, it was more of being following human being. And they forgot that human being will perish and Christ shall live. Even today, there are the people in our world who are like people who are living in a world of a beauty. They follow people in the church, but they forget that apart from those people, Christ is still reigning. We have very good people whom we have chosen to follow, but we have to abandon them sometimes and let them go and follow Christ. For Christ, he is our Redeemer. For Christ, he is the one who is ahead of us. Therefore, we serve Christ. Those people whom we are following, or whom you have chosen to follow, they will be useless. And we heard from the gospel that Christ called different people who were doing their daily work, whom their daily work, it has gone out to sea to do their fishing. Christ called them to come and be the fisher of men. Christ didn't know those people whom he was calling. And they didn't know Christ too. But they believed and they did hear Christ, who was a human being, calling them. They heard a voice of God, which was in the form of Christ, calling them. Hence, they left everything and they followed Christ. Christ who was also, or Christ who is a God from true gods. I guess many went to them to call them. I guess there were a lot of churches which were taking place. They didn't hear, but the voice that called them that day, it was a unique voice that called them to come and follow Christ. Bear in mind that they were not called to come and follow a certain person. They were called to come and follow Jesus Christ, who was a true God from true gods. And those who followed Christ, their life was transformed. And those who followed men, they perished. They were hurt when men started to do things against what promised them. We know what happens in the political world. When we move to the world, when we move to the close of the elections, it's a time when men will come and promise you that if you choose me, I'll make sure that there will be no more loss-shedding. I'll make sure that I cease the loss-shedding. But as time goes by, men will come back and say, loss-shedding is beyond my control. But those who follow Christ, Christ shall never leave them, even one day. Hence, Paul is rebuking people in Corinth that stop following people and follow Christ. Stop supporting people and support the gospel of Christ. For the gospel of Christ shall never let you down. And Christ is the center of the church. So if Christ is the center of the church, it means Christ should be the center of your hearts. Therefore, it means that in Christ, there will be no east or west, south or north, It means that in Christ's body, there won't be any division, while people will stand in one voice. There won't be a division of body, race, background, education level, income, political influence, breakdown, or there won't be hate. That's what is it is. That's how it is be. It is like to be in Christ. In Christ, there is neither Jew or Gentile, slave nor free, male or female, or Musoto, or Mubedi, or Muvenda. I know some will say Muvenda. No, it's not Muvenda, it's Muvenda. So in Christ, there isn't anything like that. In Christ, we are all equal. For God created us in his image to be equal. Therefore, my fellow brothers and sisters, we are all one in the Lord, and we should therefore be one and be united in the gospel of Christ. And our mission should not be to follow a human being, but to follow Christ, who shall sustain our life at all times. Amen.
Lord, you are our light and salvation, and there is no one like you. Today we would like to thank you, Lord, for life, for all the blessings, and the Holy Spirit are in you. You are Lord, and you are the only God we have, the Most High, and we always focus on you and not be distracted by what is going on around us. Your saving blood gave us the right to be called God's children. We are forever grateful, and may the Holy Spirit help us and strengthen us to remain in you. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you have taught us to pray and to give thanks for all people. Receive our prayers for the universal church, that it may know the power of your Holy Spirit, and that all your children may agree in the truth of your holy name and live in unity and godly love. We pray for your servant, Luca Bishop, together with Tabo, our Metropolitan, and for all other ministers of your word and sacraments, that by their life and teaching, your glory may be revealed and all nations drawn to you. Guide and prosper, we pray, those who strive for the spread of your gospel, and enlighten with your spirit all places of work, of learning, and of healing. We pray for those who have authority and responsibility among the nations, that ruling with wisdom and justice, they may promote peace and well-being in the world. To this congregation, and all your people in their different callings, give your heavenly grace, that we may hear your holy way with reverent and obedient hearts, and serve you truly all the days of our life. In your compassion, Father, comfort and heal those who are in trouble, those who are in sorrow, and those who are in need or in sickness. We praise and thank you for all your saints, for the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of Jesus Christ, our Lord, and for the heroes of the faith in every generation. And we remember before you your servants who have died, praying that we may enter with them into the fullness of your unending joy. Grant this, Holy Father, for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen.
My dear sisters and brothers, we are the body of Christ. In the one spirit, we are all baptized into one body. Let us therefore pursue all that makes for peace and build up our common life. The peace of Christ be with you always.
Thank you.
stage 106. We join together as we play the first paragraph of 48. Together we say, your God is the greatness, the power, the glory,
before you this bread and this
thank God you have made us to stand, you have made us ways to stand in your presence and save you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your Holy Church. Gather each one, all who share in these seven mysteries, filling them with the Holy Spirit and confirming their faith in the truth, that together we may praise you and give you glory through your servant, Jesus Christ. All glory and honor yours, Father, Son, with the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Church, now and forever.
Amen.
As Christ has told us, we are going to pray the Lord's Prayer together. this room will be demanding that we bring the blessing to the hall. Our service continues from page 129. We join together as we give thanks to the Lord for the body and the blood that He has kept us with. My dear sisters and brothers, give thanks to the Lord, for God is gracious. Almighty eternal God, we give you thanks for feeding us in this holy mysteries with the body and the blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and for keeping us by your grace in the body of your Son, the company of all faithful people. Help us to persevere as living members of that holy fellowship and to grow in love and obedience according to your will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lived and reigned with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. And join together as we pray, paragraph 8. Father Almighty, we offer our prayers to you as a living sacrifice in Jesus Christ.
come to a morning meeting on the 25th, this coming Wednesday, at 5:30, so that we can make this occasion a splendid one. The Women's World Day of Prayer takes place the first Friday of March every year, and this year Christ Church is leading for the churches in Poland. Next week, Saturday, the 28th, is Ordination Day. The bishop will be here to ordain new priests. There are 5 people to be ordained into priesthood. Four deacons and 1 priest. I don't know whether to say all of them. There will be 4 deacons and 1 priest ordained on Friday, the 28th. The service starts at 2 in the afternoon. And this year we will be praised by the voices of St. Mark, which is the choir. This church will have its annual vestry on the 26th of February. The annual vestry is where, among other things, we elect new leadership for the church. Those nominations that were closed on the 31st of December, they will be used as our ballot voters roll to elect new leaders for the church. And that takes place during our service on the 26th of February. For the ALF, the meeting that was scheduled for today, the message is that it's been postponed to next week. So the meeting will take place today, it will take place next week. After the service today, there will be a meeting. Council will hold its meeting in the boardroom in the parish center, and the health team will hold its meeting, first meeting, in the hall. The health team is that team of people who are interested in health issues. Not only doctors and nurses, but if you have that interest, join in the hall, so that you can be led into what they will be talking about.